It's sad, but the workplace can be a little like high school. There's cliques, a pecking order, and a science to navigate and grow between the two. We'll tell you how to do that right after the cut. Hi, everyone. Whether you realize or not, with almost every interaction you have at the workplace, you're being judged. It's a game, and how you play it can label you as a team player or a lone wolf. Whether it's volunteering to manage the office holiday party, agreeing to come out for a drink with your coworkers after hours, or staying late to help your boss finish a project, there are always these small choices that can indirectly impact how people think about you at work. Of course, you don't always have to say yes to every request asked of you, but especially as a student or a recent grad, there are times when saying the right thing or going that extra mile can work to your favor professionally. To navigate those waters, the team at jobpostings.ca put together the following tips to help you work more politically. So, one of the most obvious times to play office politics is when the boss or manager is around. Basically, whenever there's an event or a meeting with a higher up, do your best to attend or be part of them. In this context, being seen really matters. The more face time you have with the boss, the more likely they'll remember who you are and the more regularly they'll think about you for future projects or positions. It's also a chance to meet and directly engage with your manager so that they learn your name, the projects you're working on, and the results or successes you've achieved so far. It's a chance to get some extra attention and recognition for yourself. Another thing to keep in mind is that if company cutbacks happen in the future, management is more likely to let go of those people who don't seem active or visible within the office group. Another time when people play office politics is when you're gunning for that raise or promotion. The reality is that raises and promotions aren't offered freely. You have to ask for them. And it's the quality of your relationships with your managers and coworkers alongside your basic work performance that will see you get that raise or promotion. That's why when you're confident you want to stay at a company for the next 1 to 3 years, you need to start planning early for that promotion. Invest at least 6 months into getting more involved with office extracurriculars, being more active when collabing with your coworkers, and staying a little late more often to help out the boss on important projects. Finally, the last thing we'll bring up today is the office politics around networking. Just like when you're looking for a raise or promotion, if you're gunning to change departments or get selected to be part of a higher profile company project, it's the relationships you have in the company that will make that happen. To build those relationships, you basically have to jump on any opportunity you can to hang out with coworkers and managers outside of the office. Whether that's at a conference, company volunteer function, or even at the local pub, look for opportunities where you can hang out with the people you work with. All in all, knowing when and when not to play the office politics game depends on the unique dynamics of your office and the people you work with. But if you play the game right, your career will grow faster than you expect. Thanks so much for watching this jobpostings.ca job hunt video. Be sure to leave a comment below and tell us what you thought about today's career tips. Maybe you have a couple of your own you'd like to share. And if you have any questions about this video or have requests for future job tip videos, please let us know. We'll do our best to answer everybody. In the meantime, if you like this video, please click the like button or share it with your friends. And don't forget to click the subscribe button just down below.